on the pharmacology of analgesics. Pain can be extremely debilitating and cause long-term morbidity. Analgesics are a group comprised of various classes of medications which provide relief from pain and are some of the most commonly prescribed medications worldwide. In this tutorial, we will be concerned with the pharmacology of the following analgesics: non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, or NSAIDs, and opioids. To begin with, let's take a look at a representation of the anatomy and physiology involved in pain transmission. Relevant anatomy includes peripheral nerve fibers, the dorsal root ganglion, the spinal cord, spinothalamic tract, medulla, periaqueductal gray of the midbrain, the thalamus, and the primary somatosensory area of the cerebral cortex. When trauma occurs at a peripheral site, peripheral nerve fibers are stimulated and an action potential is created, transmitting information about tissue damage along the nerve to the dorsal root ganglion. This eventually synapses with a second-order neuron within the dorsal horn of the spinal cord in a region called the substantia gelatinosa. This second-order neuron decussates, or crosses, the spinal cord at this level before entering the spinothalamic tract and rising through the medulla, the periaqueductal gray of the midbrain, and then synapses with a third-order neuron within the thalamus. This third-order neuron then continues on, ending at the primary somatosensory region of the cerebral cortex. Let's look at the mechanism by which trauma in peripheral tissues causes this sequence of events to occur. Trauma stimulates the enzyme phospholipase A2 to act on phospholipids in the tissue, metabolizing these to arachidonic acid. Arachidonic acid is acted on by a number of enzymes, including cyclooxygenase 2, or COX2, which produces endoperoxidase, which are in turn converted into a number of prostaglandins. These prostaglandins and other chemical mediators produced by the trauma cause inflammation and the stimulation of free nerve endings, which result in pain transmission. However, this process can be interrupted by the use of non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, such as ibuprofen, which acts to block the action of cyclooxygenase 2, providing relief for pain of mild to medium severity. Another group of medications which block the transmission of pain are opioids. Opioids such as morphine act on opioid receptors at a number of sites to block the transmission of severe pain by reducing the amount of neuropeptides and neurotransmitters such as substance P and glutamate available to continue pain transmission. Opioid receptors are G-protein coupled receptors, and there are three subtypes. These are delta, kappa, and mu. When opioids bind to mu1 receptors, they cause analgesia and are responsible for physical dependence. Opioids binding to mu2 receptors cause many of the side effects associated with opioid use, including respiratory depression, meiosis, euphoria, and reduced gastrointestinal motility. Opioids act at opioid receptors to reduce pain transmission within the substantia gelatinosa of the dorsal horn of the spinal cord. They also act in the medulla, the thalamus, and at the primary somatosensory region of the cerebral cortex. In addition to this effect, the binding of opioids to opioid receptors in the periaqueductal gray of the midbrain causes stimulation of the descending inhibitory pathways, which acts to further reduce pain transmission and plays an important part in the analgesic effect of opioids.